Hello, today we'll discuss about for loop in Python. A for loop allows the Python to keep repeating code. It means that if you use for loop, it will repeat number of times your iteration. Like this way, here is the example for I in range of 1 to 10 print I. It means that it will repeat 1 to 10 up to 10 and it will print 1 to 9. In this example, it would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 9. It will count from 1 and it will end as a 10. So remember to indent the line of code with the for loop. Means here you can keep as a space. So then only it will work. Now we will go for Python code. And here you can see that ask the user to enter their name and then display their name as a two type. Here I have write row name is equal to input type your name for I in range of 0 to 3 print the name. So here you can see that here we have to write two times. So I will keep two times. And if I run this code, first it will ask my name. I will write and it will print that name in two times. So here you can see that Hare Krishna and Hare Krishna, name of name and number, and then display their name at that the number of times. Here you can see that I had to input number of times. So here you can see that in for loop I in range of 0 to which number which I input as a here, it will go here and it will rotate this for loop number of times with this number. If you run this code, I'll first write my name and enter number of time, it will repeat. If I write six times, it will write six times my names. Here you can see that. Ask the user to enter their name and display each letter in their name on a separate line. So if I write Hare Krishna, it will output as a different at a different sentence. So first I will same thing, name input type your name for I in name. So here you can see that I in the name and then print I. So first it will go for this Hare Krishna, and by this Hare Krishna first letter for I this equal to 1, and then it will print H, then again it will repeat A, then again for R, then again for I. If I run this code, it will give my value, means give my name in every sentence. Ask the user to enter number between 1 to 10, 10 and then display 10 times table for that number. Here you can see that num is equal to integer. Input number as a number between 1 to 10 for I in range of 1 to 11. Because it will start with 1, we have to ensure that it will be positive, means plus 1. Then only it will work as a 10 times. Answer is equal to I multiply by number. So 1 multiply which I will into this one. So if I put, I will run this code. I will write 5. Here you can see that 5 table is available. So 5 multiply by this 1 equal to 5. So this is print I, this means I, this is a character X, this I num. So we have entered 5 and answer is equal to 5. So 2 multiply by 5 is equal to 10, 3 multiply by 5 is equal to 15, as same way 10 multiply by 5 is equal to 15. If you want to change this here, I will write num and here I will write I. Then we can see that 5 multiply by 1 is equal to 5, 5 multiply by 2 is equal to 10. So guys, this is repeating this code every time. Same thing, another example, ask for number below 10, 40 and then count down from 40 to that number. Make sure that show the number they enter in output. So num is equal to, we will write our number for I in range of 40, num minus 1 means 39 times and minus 1. It will decrease my value by 1 time, minus 1 time. If I run this code, I will write 40. Sorry. I will write 30. It will give my result 40, 39, 38 up to 30. Why it is showing 30? If I don't write minus 1, it will not show 30 value. I have to write minus 1. So here you can see that every number you have to just add 1 or just minus 1. If you want whatever you like, you have to do like this way. Set of variable called to total 0. Ask the user to enter 5 number. Here you can see that I will input as a every number and it will total my this number. Here you can see that enter my number is 2, enter my number is 3 and 4, and it will total my number is 9. It will print total 1. So first I will write total is equal to 0. Initially I will calculate total is equal to 0 for I in range of 3, means I will input as a 3 times. Num is equal to, it will write my enter the num, means enter this number equation and answer. If you do you want to add this number, means if you write yes, then it will give total is equal to this summation, means 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, it will answer that. If I run this code, enter the number, I will write 5. Do you want to add this number? I will say yes. Enter the number, I will write 8. Do you want to add this number? I will say no. I don't want to number 8. And enter the number 10. Do you want to add this number? I will say yes. And it will answer give me as a 15. So 5 plus 10 is equal to 15. It will not enter my this addition this my number to 8. By this way you can simulate your code. This is same thing, direction direct the here we can see that I had kept if loop. In that I will use for loop for this equation. Here you can see that it is very simple code of countdown up or it is down. If you choose countdown as a up, what is your top number? If you write as a here I example 15, it will give your enter up to 15. So if I run this code, here you can see that if direction upward, then it will start with 1 plus num plus 1. Means here you can see that if I write 15, so here you can see that I have add the number. So every time you want to see your number, you have to just add plus 1. Then here you can see that I have kept the minus because I want to decrease my number indent value. So if I run this code, I will say down number below 10, I will say 10. So it will go for 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, like this way, you can see that. Now I will, this is a marriage invitation for people. Num is equal to in how many people do you want to invite your marriage. If number is 10, then it will run this for loop, and else it will print too many people for for loop. If I write this number here, you can see that num. So if I write 3 as a number, it will run for loop for 3 times, and then it will ask for name which I want to invite for my marriage, and then print name has been invited. If I run this code, if you, I will say 5 people and enter name Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna has been invited. I will say Vishal. I will say Akash. I will say Chignesh. I will say Chignesh. Okay. So by this way you can see that my for loop is working. Thank you guys. Please share and subscribe to my video.